Hi everybody, it's Miss Melanie. Welcome to week four of distance learning. Week four. There's so many ways to make the number four. This week in math, we are continuing. We're gonna be finishing up the chapter that we started last week in our math books, and that is counting on to add. So I'm not really going to go through a lesson because it's really just refining their skills in counting on to add. But I am going to give you a couple tips and tricks because Miss Cindy and I noticed last week when we started teaching it that some of the kids are still having a hard time starting at the beginning number and counting on. They want to start at one and we do not want that. So when you're doing homework at home, or if you're doing distance learning and you're teaching from home, I'm going to give you a couple of tips that we've been trying to help the kids get where they need to be so that we can move on. First of all, number one thing that I would say is to have them get this number. If we have this problem 6 + 3, we want to start at 6, so we don't want them going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9. We don't want that. We want them starting at 6. So have them get 6 in their brain. 6, 6, 6, 6. Think about the numbers that are around 6. Think about what number comes next after 6. Okay? And then you're going to have them get out 3 counters or 3 beans or 3 whatever you have at home that you have 3 that you have 10 of that they can use. You're gonna have them get 3 of them out, okay? And then you're going to 6, 6, 6. What number comes after 6? Oh, 7. Okay, ready? 6, 7. Have them count the counters. 8, 9. Have them use their fingers if you don't have something they at home that they can use. Works the same way, but it really helps the kids to have something physical that they can count on with. Because they're already keeping in their brain that 6. They already have in their brain that 6. So that brain is occupying their mind. So it's really hard for them to count on in their brain. So they need something physical that they can count. So 6, 7, 8, 9. Hold 3 fingers up for them if that helps them. 6. Count my fingers. 7, 8, 9. Whatever works. You can also draw dots. You're starting at 6, and then we're gonna count on the other 3. 6, 7, 8, 9. What's your answer? Sometimes when I was teaching last week, I don't know about Miss Cindy, but sometimes I would ask them what their answer is and they wanted to say 3 was their answer because that's what they were just counting. So do it over again. 6, 7, 8, 9. What's your answer? 9 is your answer. Remember when you're doing this that if your child is really having a hard time counting to 20, that's something that we should be practicing. You'll notice if they're having a hard time counting to 20, we have several of them that are still kind of struggling with that. And we're working on it at school, and if you're working on it at home, they'll get it down. Don't let them skip their teen numbers, because if they're continuously miscounting, then once we get up to higher numbers, they're going to continuously get their answers incorrect, even though they're doing it correctly. And we don't want that. We don't want to discourage them just because they're having a hard time counting. So keep counting at home, 1 through 20. Have them count things for you. Have them count things at the grocery store. Have them count number of cars that they see when you're in the car. This is an activity that you can do anywhere and everywhere, and it's a really good one to practice. Have them saying it out loud, and if they miss a number, stop them and correct them right then. If they skip 14, which is a very common number to skip, they say 13, they go to 15, stop. Okay, what number comes after 3? 4. What number comes after 13? 14. Okay, try again. Start from the beginning. Or another great activity is have them start from just any random number between 1 and 20. Hey, I want you to count to 20 starting at 9. 9, 10, 11, Don't always have them count at one. That will help with this math tremendously. Okay, so your math this week is in, it's already in your binder or in your packets. It's on that math schedule. We will be continuing on with this here at school on, not this week, but the following Monday. Once we're all done with the chapter, we're going to be giving them the chapter quiz to see how they're doing. If we have a majority of the class that is still not doing well, then we will reteach, find new ways to teach the content until everyone gets it down. If you're at home and you're doing distance learning, then please wait until you're all done with the chapter and then give them that quiz one. Quiz number one, take a picture of both sides, send it to Miss Cindy either on Blooms or email or text it to me or whatever is the easiest way for you to send it. I will let you know if they did not do well on the quiz, then I will have you give them quiz number two after you do a little bit of reteaching and I can guide you on how to do that. We do have two quizzes, but the second one is only after some reteaching is happening. You do not have to give both quizzes. If they do well on the first quiz, you do not have to give the second quiz. That's only if you need it. Same here. If the kids do well on the first quiz, they're not going to have to take the second quiz. So, I think that is all for this week. If, like I said, if you have any questions, please, please, please reach out to Miss Cindy or I know that this addition can get tricky, especially when you've just been used to counting and you're not used to adding. Oh, another thing, this symbol right here. We noticed that some of the kids really have no clue what that means. It's important that they know that that means add. Have them make the sign with their hands or their arms. Show me the addition symbol. Show me what it looks like, the plus sign looks like. I taught them both words. I'm not sure about Miss Cindy. Addition sign and plus sign. They should know that it means that they're putting things together. They're making a bigger number. Okay, don't worry about subtraction sign yet because they're not doing subtraction. They need to know that that means they're making a bigger number. Bigger number. Okay, they're adding. Okay, so that's another thing that we can practice at home. I think that's it. If you have any questions, anything that you need help with, if you need anything from us, please let us know. We are here to support and help in any way that we can. We just want the best for your kids. So have a great week. I hope you all had a great Labor Day weekend, and we will see you soon. Thank you. Bye.